Hello there, very good evening and welcome to the news tonight here on Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Tracy Shilshi and in the next 30 minutes I'll be getting you these top stories from India and across the world. Let's start with the headlines. Rajya Sabha passes the Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2016 and the Dentists Amendment Bill 2016. The two bills put the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test in place. Expelled AIADMK member Shashikala Pushpa seeks protection in Rajya Sabha, claims threat to her life after she is expelled from the AIADMK. Anandiben Patel quits as Gujarat Chief Minister. BJP President Amit Shah says resignation will be put in front of the Parliamentary Board Committee for further action. Disciplinary panel of the National Anti-Doping Agency clears Narsingh Yadav. The passage is now cleared for him to head to the Rio Olympics. And a truck bomb kills a policeman and injures four others in the Afghan capital Kabul. Taliban claims responsibility for the attack. Top story this evening. Parliament today approved two significant bills to put the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test, or NEET, in place. The Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2016 and the Dentist Amendment Bill 2016, which were approved by the Lok Sabha earlier, was passed by Rajya Sabha by voice vote. With NEET, government now aims to curb corruption by bringing in transparency and check multiplicity of exams. NEET will come into effect from next year. The admission to medical and dental courses will be done through a single common entrance test across the country. Now, the AIADMK had opposed the bill and staged a walkout, arguing that it will affect rural students who do not study CBSE syllabus. The health minister, however, assured that this will not affect state quota and it will be on state governments to decide and give the extra marks and give admissions to the reserved categories.
हम लोगों ने स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स को लिख दिया है कि पिछले तीन सालों में आपके यहाँ स्टेट्स में किस-किस लैंग्वेजेस में आपने एग्जामिनेशन लिया है उसको हमको आप बताएं और उसके अकॉर्डिंगली द एग्जामिनेशंस विल टेक प्लेस अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर लैंग्वेजेस
सो इट इज रिजर्वेशन इज आवर बर्थ राइट इट इज इन प्रैक्टिस वी आर फॉलोइंग इट इन फोर्स सो द नीट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस नीट एग्जामिनेशन डेफिनेटली रूरल पुअर स्टूडेंट्स will be affected.
आप एग्जिट एग्जाम कंपलसरी कर दीजिए आपको जो ये आशंका है कि कहीं क्वालिटी खराब ना हो जाए
इस डोनेशन के सिस्टम को आप इस एग्जाम के साथ खत्म करेंगे नहीं करेंगे जो प्राइवेट लोग हैं प्राइवेट कॉलेज हैं ये रिजर्वेशन जो सरकारी अस्पताल में होता है ये प्राइवेट अस्पताल में होगा कि नहीं होगा
सीइंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ द नेशनल बोर्ड ऑन एग्जामिनेशन डज नॉट गिव मी एनी कॉन्फिडेंस व्हाटसोएवर that this government has the courage to stand up to the vested interests of the Medical Council of India and accept the recommendations of the Standing Committee.
Meanwhile, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj today assured Lok Sabha that efforts had been stepped up to help 10,000 Indian workers facing starvation in Saudi Arabia after they were rendered jobless. Swaraj informed the lower house that the government was taking the issue seriously and the Minister of State, retired General V.K. Singh, will soon leave for Saudi Arabia to look into the matter. The Union Minister also informed the House that the government has asked Saudi Arabia's foreign and labour departments to issue emergency visas to Indians to allow them to return. Under Saudi law, workers have to first take permission letters from the company, but the companies that had employed them have already left the country.
परसों मुझे इस बात की जानकारी मिली कि हमारे वर्कर्स वहाँ फंसे हुए हैं और वो भूखे प्यासे हैं तुरंत मैंने इंडियन एम्बेसी रियाद और सीजी जद्दा से बात करके ये कहा कि पांच कैंपों में जहाँ वो वर्कर्स रह रहे हैं तुरंत फ्री राशन वितरण करने का काम करो आखिरी संदेश मुझे रात के 2:45 बजे आया कि इस समय पाँचों कैंपों में राशन वितरण का काम पूरा हो गया है रात 2:45 बजे तक एम्बेसी और जद्दा सीजी के लोग साथ में इंडियन कम्युनिटी के लोग मिलकर राशन वितरित करते रहे और हफ्ते 10 दिन का राशन हर कैंप में देकर आए
And Sushma Swaraj made a similar announcement in Rajya Sabha as well. Here are more details.
The government has stepped up efforts to help nearly 10,000 Indian workers in Saudi Arabia facing starvation after being rendered jobless. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj informed the Rajya Sabha during Zero Hour that the Indian embassy in Saudi Arabia has been directed to serve food and that she was monitoring the situation on an hourly basis. Swaraj also stressed that the government will take steps to ensure that the Indian workers get their salary arrears and exit visa.
लेबर ऑफिस से हमने कहा कि 8-8 महीने का बकाया नहीं, कईयों का तो बहुत-बहुत दिनों का बकाया है, तो इसलिए आप हमसे इनके कॉन्ट्रैक्ट साइन करवाइए, जिसमें जब भी आप इन कंपनियों के साथ सेटल करें, तो उनका पूरा बकाया वेतन हमारे श्रमिकों को दिया जा सके, और अब मैं स्वयं जनरल वीके सिंह को वहाँ भेज रही हूँ, वो कल वहाँ चले जाएंगे, फॉरेन ऑफिस और लेबर ऑफिस दोनों से बात करके इन सबके हम लोग रजिस्टर करेंगे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, ताकि इनको सारा का सारा बकाया पैसा यहाँ वापस आने पर भी मिल सके और इनको सबको स्वदेश वापस लेकर के आएंगे.
Swaraj was seeking to allay fears of members who expressed concern over the Indians starving in Saudi Arabia.
बिहार के 700 मजदूर जा करके जद्दा में फंसे हुए हैं, इसलिए कि यहाँ काम नहीं मिलता है, वहाँ रोज रोटी के लिए तड़प रहे हैं. कारखाना मालिक ने, वहाँ की कंपनी ने 8 महीने से उनका वेतन बंद कर रखा है.
वहाँ की सरकार जो उन पर एट्रोसिटी कर रही है, जेलों में बंद है, उनको रोटी नहीं मिल रहा, काम से उनके पासपोर्ट जमा कर लिए गए. सिमन, ये तो एक निर्दयता का एक तरीका हो गया. यहाँ का लेबर जा रहा है और उसको उस तरह हो रहा है. मैं सुषमा जी से कहूँगा कि इसको गंभीरता से लें.
हमें जो है लीगल असिस्टेंस की सुविधा करानी चाहिए और लोगों को मदद करने के लिए वहाँ पे एक सेल बनानी चाहिए स्पेशल, तभी ये समस्या हल हो सकती है. अगर हम लाखों मजदूरों सबको वापस बुला लेंगे, डोमेस्टिक वर्कर सबको, उससे समस्या हल नहीं होने वाली.
The ongoing dip in oil prices has forced the Saudi government to slash spending since last year, putting a strain on local construction firms that rely on state contracts. Many companies are struggling to pay foreign workers and have laid off thousands, leaving them jobless and famished. On Saturday, the Consulate General of India in Jeddah, in association with the Indian community, distributed 15,475 kilos of food to the workers over the past 3 days. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, expelled AIADMK member and Rajya Sabha MP Shashikala Pushpa claimed in Rajya Sabha today that there was a threat to her life after being sacked from her party. She also alleged that there was pressure on her to resign from the upper house. Deputy Chairman of the House PJ Kurian assured that the needful will be done to ensure her safety and security.
If a woman can be expelled AIADMK member Shashikala Pushpa sought protection in the Rajya Sabha, stating that she apprehended threat to her life. Shashikala said she wished to serve the public and did not want to resign from the Rajya Sabha.
I need protection.
No, don't bring those things.
Government's protection.
Don't bring those things.
I need government's protection.
Okay, all right.
Pushpa found support from both the Congress and the Samajwadi Party.
She has not been allowed to speak whatever she wanted to speak. She should be allowed. This can happen with any member of this house. Since this is from opposition, this can happen with the ruling party. I do not know what is the reason. But how come a member of our parliament is not being allowed to express her views?
तो पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर में भी आता है, उसको कहने का पूरा अधिकार है.
I am not preventing.
अगर वो कह रही है कि उसकी जान,
Why do you say I am preventing?
अगर उसकी जान में खतरा है, तो फिर
I was only I didn't prevent it.
Deputy Chairman PJ Kurian asked Shashikala to write to the Rajya Sabha Chairman about the alleged threat to her life and assured the House's support. The government also sought to downplay the controversy in the interest of the dignity of the House and assured her of safety.
Government will take care of her protection if necessary. She will write to Honorable Chairman. We will do the needful. I can assure on behalf of the Honorable Chairman, we will do the needful in this matter.
A humble suggestion to the Chair and also to the House. This discussion is not going to add to the glory of the House. And secondly, if the member has got any problem with regard to her security, the best way, according to me, is writing to the Chairman.
I told her.
And then Chairman will take appropriate action.
Yeah.
That's what you have said. So let us proceed further and go to the
That's correct.
Monday's developments came in the wake of reports that Shashikala Pushpa slapped DMK Rajya Sabha MP Tiruchi Shiva at an airport. Shashikala claimed that she was provoked by Tiruchi Shiva making uncharitable remarks about the AIADMK and its cadre. Later, both members apologized to each other for the incident. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And staying with Rajya Sabha, opposition members took exception to remarks allegedly made by Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar. Members alleged that Parrikar was threatening minorities and demanded the Prime Minister's assurance to ensure their security. Defending himself, the Defence Minister, however, claimed that he did not threaten anyone.
Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar faced the heat in the Rajya Sabha from a united opposition. Raising the issue during Zero Hour, TMC MP Derek O'Brien alleged that at a time when religious fundamentalism is on the rise, the Defence Minister is intimidating citizens.
First time if it happens, sir, we can call it a mistake. Second time if it happens, sir, we can call it a bigger mistake. Third time if it happens, we can call it a blunder. But if it happens and happens and happens, I have to say, sir, it is a decision. I believe this is happening not because of a mistake. This is a decision of this government, sir. Otherwise, let me tell you, sir. One, the defense minister of this country would not have said what he said yesterday.
Other opposition parties joined in to target Parrikar for his alleged remarks. Members also demanded the Prime Minister's response in the House to assuage the collective angst of minorities and Dalits.
Defence Minister and Home Minister.
No, that's what I'm saying.
They are supposed to protect the territorial integrity of the country.
Let me say.
Is this the way of protecting the territorial integrity of the country? You are alienating your own people.
Yeah, please.
You are alienating your own country.
No.
Pure desh mein धार्मिक अल्पसंख्यक समाज में से खास तौर से मुस्लिम समाज के लोगों को इन्होंने अपना निशाना बनाया, उनका हर प्रकार से उत्पीड़न किया गया और अब पूरे देश के अंदर दलितों के साथ भी बड़े पैमाने पर उत्पीड़न हो रहा है। हमारी पार्टी ये चाहती है कि प्रधानमंत्री जी हाउस के अंदर आए और ये बताएं कि देश के अंदर ये सब कुछ क्या हो रहा है।
इतने इम्पोर्टेंट पद पर बैठे हुए व्यक्ति को सीधे सीधे कम्युनिटी को पूरी माइनॉरिटी को धमकाने की बात कही जाए, पाठ पढ़ाने की बात कही जाए।
Now he is denied.
मैंने वीडियो देखा है
सर, ये रक्षा मंत्री है। ये अगर रक्षा मंत्री है, अगर रक्षा मंत्री है तो किसका रक्षा हो रहा है? उसका रक्षा हो रहा है।
Parrikar, however, denied making any damaging remarks. He clarified that his words did not point out at anyone.
What is quoted is not what I have said.
Yeah, that is what he said.
I never took name of anyone.
He said he didn't say that.
Deputy Chairman P.J. Kurian then urged members to raise specific issues against the Defence Minister in accordance to the rules. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
In other news, Gujarat Chief Minister Anandibeen Patel has submitted her resignation. She had offered to resign earlier, asking the BJP High Command to start the process of selecting a new Chief Minister. In a letter, she had stated that she wanted to step down as Chief Minister when she turns 75 on the 21st of November. She also submitted her resignation to Party President Amit Shah and State BJP Chief Vijay Rupani. A final decision on her resignation will be taken by the BJP Parliamentary Board. Anandibeen Patel was under pressure as the BJP fared badly in the rural civic bodies polls in December 2015, with the opposition Congress making significant gains. The fierce Patel community quota agitation and the more recent Dalit uprising after the Una thrashing incident has also dented the image of the party.
2017 के अंत में गुजरात में विधानसभा के चुनाव आने वाले हैं और राज्य में हर दो साल के बाद होने वाली महत्वपूर्ण वाइब्रेंट गुजरात समिट में भी जनवरी 2017 में आने वाली है। नवनियुक्त मुख्यमंत्री को पूर्ण समय मिले, इसलिए मैंने दो माह पहले पार्टी के वरिष्ठ नेतृत्व के सामने इस जिम्मेदारी से मुक्त होने की विनंती की थी। मैं इस फिर से इस पत्र के माध्यम से पार्टी के वरिष्ठ नेतृत्व को मुझे मुख्यमंत्री पद की जिम्मेदारी से मुक्त करने की विनती करती हूँ।
उन्होंने कहा है कि नवंबर में उनके 75 साल समाप्त हो रहे हैं और क्योंकि जो नया व्यक्ति पार्टी लाना चाहती है उसको एक समय मिलना चाहिए, तो इसलिए उन्होंने स्वयं अपने पद से मुक्त करने के लिए पार्टी को रिक्वेस्ट की है। अब ये इन्होंने जो पत्र मुझे लिखा है मैं पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड के सामने रखूंगा और पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड उस पर निर्णय करेगा।
Already there are reports of who could be replacing her. We'll keep an eye for developments there. But now let's head on to Kashmir, where one suspected terrorist was killed by security forces in Nogam sector on Monday. Meanwhile, normal life remained paralyzed in Kashmir for the 24th consecutive day as curfew continued in some parts to maintain law and order.
One militant was killed in an infiltration bid near the line of control in Nogam sector of Kashmir. One AK-47 was recovered from the dead terrorist. This is the third infiltration bid fought in the Nogam sector in the past 6 days. Meanwhile, with little signs of improvement in the prevalent situation across Kashmir, curfew remains in force in Anantnag town. Other major towns of South Kashmir, including Pulwama, Shopian and Avantipura, are witnessing strict restrictions. Restrictions are also in place in 5 police station areas in Srinagar. Shops, schools, colleges and private offices remained closed. Public transport also remained off the roads. Mobile internet services continue to remain snapped.
Now, violence is continuing, which is why in some places curfew continues. And it is up to security forces to take a call as to when the matters come completely under control. And for this, it has to happen from both ends. Those who have caused disturbances and violence must cease and become peaceful. And otherwise, till then, the toll is likely to rise.
Pakistani flags were waved and pro-militant slogans raised at a rally organized by separatists in Pulwama district on Sunday. According to sources, alleged top terrorist of the Pakistani group Lashkar-e-Taiba, Abu Dujana, was also spotted in the rally.
Abu Dujan has been responsible for several killings and militant activities. And he is openly participating in the separatist rallies in Kashmir. The government should have acted tough against these people.
The separatist camp has extended the shutdown call in Kashmir till August 5, calling for a march to the Hazrat Bal Shrine. The present unrest began following the killing of Hizbul Mujahideen commander Burhan Wani on July 8. The violence left 49 persons dead and over 5,600 persons injured. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The flood situation remains grim in Assam and Bihar, with almost every river in the two states flowing above the danger mark. In Odisha, 41 people have died due to lightning strikes in 10 districts of the state since Sunday. In fact, the weatherman has predicted more rains or thunder showers over the north and south of Odisha, along with gusty winds. Uttar Pradesh as well continue to receive heavy downpour, with many rivers flowing near or above the danger mark, creating flood-like situations in several villages.
Flood fury is showing no mercy as situation in Bihar and Assam worsens. All major rivers in Assam are overflowing due to the continuous heavy rainfall, submerging 2,266 villages across 21 districts. 31 people have lost their lives and nearly 17 lakhs are displaced. 1.5 lakh people are forcibly living in 463 relief camps. The Met Department has forecast more rain and thunder showers in the next 24 hours in Assam.
क्या कहेंगे सरकार अभी जब इलेक्शन का टाइम होगा तब सामने आ जाते हैं अभी तो मुख छुपा के बैठा हुआ है कोई नहीं अभी तक तो कोई भी नहीं आ रहा है.
The situation is not so good in Bihar either. The flood toll stands at 26 and an estimated 27.5 lakh people have been affected in over 2,000 villages across 12 districts. Incessant rainfall followed by floods have also damaged crops in 3.39 lakh hectares of land.
डर क्या रहता है पानी आता है फंसने का डर है बच्चे हैं छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं कहाँ लेके जाऊँ कैसे लेके जाऊँ नाव ऐसा है जिसमें पानी नाव भी पानी बहते रहता है नाव पानी भरा रहता है उसमें भी डर होता है नाव पे भी जाने में.
A massive landslide also occurred in Shimla due to the heavy downpour, blocking the crucial National Highway 5, leaving hundreds of tourists stranded.
हम दो दिन से फंसे हुए हैं और दो दिन से फंसने के बाद ना तो यहाँ पे हमें खाना भी जो है वो रेट टू रेट नहीं वो डबल टिबल ट्रिपल कि अगर यहाँ पे 100 रुपए की थाली तो 400 की दे रहे हैं और चाय 50 रुपए की दे रहे हैं कि हर तरीके से दिक्कत में है.
Heavy rain also wreaked havoc in Maharashtra's Bhiwandi district, where a building collapsed, burying alive 9 people. Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar undertook an aerial survey of Gurugram after heavy rainfall triggered waterlogging and traffic jams in the city 2 days ago.
जो ड्रेन बादशाहपुर ड्रेन है वो जगह जगह उसको एक प्रकार से एनक्रोचमेंट भी हुई है जगह जगह उसकी जितनी सफाई होनी चाहिए थी वो सफाई भी नहीं है। लगता है कि हमको कुछ ना कुछ का जरूर एक ऑपरेशन ऐसा जरूर करना पड़ेगा जिसके कारण से पानी आगे इतनी बरसात है कभी न रुके।
However, showers on Monday evening brought much relief to Delhiites as they enjoyed from the humid conditions. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
With a quick break here, we'll be back with the international news in a bit. Stay with us.
Gyan Chopper is the ancient version of Indian snakes and ladders. This intriguing game was popular among the old, the young, and the rulers as well. The Chopper has its origin in the Jain philosophy. It tells the story of virtue, symbolized by the ladders, rewarded, while the vices shown by the snakes are punished. Each square, in turn, also narrates some message of wisdom.
Welcome back. Let's get to international news now. One policeman was killed and four others injured in a truck bombing incident at a compound in Kabul early Monday morning. The bombing occurred outside the Northgate Hotel on the eastern outskirts of the Afghan capital after attackers detonated a truck bomb. Three gunmen then tried to enter the facility, triggering a gun battle with security forces. All three of them were killed in the gunfight that ensued. The Taliban has claimed responsibility for the attack.
Taliban insurgents attacked a hotel compound housing foreign contractors on the outskirts of Kabul early on Monday morning. The gunmen triggered a massive truck bomb outside the Northgate Hotel before trying to enter the heavily guarded facility. In the gunfight that followed, security forces killed all the three terrorists. A policeman was also killed, while four others were injured.
Bain raftan az asar enemy intihar ne dar camp bar kas tawan rasida ba hech kas tawan rasida wale police ma ke dar qadam awal rasid inara az dukhulshan ba camp ya ba enemy sharkata.
The Afghan Special Operation Forces were called to launch a counter-attack. The huge sound of the explosion triggered panic among local residents as the city plunged into darkness. The Taliban that claimed responsibility for the attack called the hotel a place of vulgarity and profanity. It was the second attack on the hotel that is frequented by foreigners. Earlier in 2013, Taliban militants attacked the building with a car bomb. The recent attack comes after twin bombings that left 80 people dead in Kabul on 23rd of July. It was the deadliest attack since the Taliban were removed from power in 2001. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Turkey's post-coup crackdown continues. 11 more soldiers were arrested on Monday, believed to be part of the group that launched an attack on the hotel where President Recep Tayyip Erdogan was holidaying on the night of the coup. More than 60,000 people have been arrested or detained in Turkey since the failed coup bid.
Turkish special forces on Monday captured 11 more soldiers suspected of being involved in last month's failed coup attempt against President Recep Tayyip Erdogan. According to the state media, the fugitives were located in a forested area in the Mughla province and were caught after heavy gunfire with the security forces. Soon after their arrest, dozens of anti-coup protesters gathered outside the police station and booed them. The 11 soldiers were part of a group that launched an attack on the hotel where President Erdogan was holidaying on the night of 15 July. Having been tipped off, Erdogan had fled the hotel by the time the soldiers arrived. A total of 36 soldiers were reportedly involved in the operation to seize Erdogan. While 25 of them were arrested earlier, the remaining 11 were caught in an overnight operation on Monday. Meanwhile, thousands of Kurds also rallied against the attempted coup in Diyarbakir, saying the country needs to build a strong democracy and reforms.
Askeri darbeler önlenir ama buna rağmen hiçbir zaman Türkiye güçlü demokrasiye götürmedikleri için bizzat kendi anti-demokratik uygulamalarıyla Türkiye'de darbelere zemin hazırladı.
However, they made it clear that standing against the coup did not necessarily mean support for the ruling AK party and President Erdogan.
15 Temmuz akşamı da darbeye karşı çıkmak AKP'yi desteklemek demek değildir. Demokrasi mücadelesine sunulan bir destektir. Halkın özgürlük arayışına sunulan bir destektir. Biz de bugün bunun için meydanlardayız.
Turkey dismissed nearly 1400 members of its armed forces and stacked the top military council with government ministers on Sunday, a move said to be designed by President Erdogan to put him in full control of the military after the failed coup. So far, more than 60,000 people in the military, judiciary, civil services and schools have either been detained, suspended or placed under investigation since the 15-16 July coup. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And now some sports news. And the National Anti-Doping Agency has given a clean sheet to wrestler Narsingh Yadav, clearing the way for him to participate in the 74-kilogram freestyle category at the Rio Olympics. According to the agency, Narsingh Yadav was a victim of sabotage and police probe also backs the wrestler. Panel also said that the wrestler deserved the benefit of doubt. However, there are clouds over his participation in the Olympics as his replacement has already reached Rio. But the Wrestling Federation of India said that Narsingh would now be brought back into the squad. Narsingh Yadav failed two dope tests ahead of the Rio Olympics and had earlier filed an FIR against a junior wrestler for allegedly mixing supplements into his food.
The panel is treating this as a single violation because the report of the sample taken on 25th June was not notified to him till the sample taken on 5th July. For the reasons said above, panel concludes that the athlete deserves the benefit of Article 10.4 of the anti-doping rules of NADA 2015, as there is no fault or negligence on his part and he is a victim of sabotage done by a competitor.
बिल्कुल जैसे कि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने इस गरीब खिलाड़ी को इतना साथ दिया और उन्होंने इतना जल्दी सब मैटर सॉल्व किया और मैं उनका तहे दिल से धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूं. यहां पे जो भी मीडिया और जनता में और हमारी भारतीय जो खेल मंत्रालय है और सभी का मैं तहे दिल से आभारी हूं कि सभी ने मेरा सपोर्ट किया, सभी ने सच्चाई का साथ दिया और मुझे न्याय दिलाया. और मैं मीडिया लोग खास करके बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगा कि आप लोगों ने हमेशा मेरे कई बार जो पॉजिटिव किसी खिलाड़ी का आज तक किसी मीडिया ने मतलब साथ नहीं दिया, आप लोगों ने मेरा साथ दिया और मुझे इतना आप लोगों ने उठाया कि मुझे न्याय मिला, तो आप सबका मैं धन्यवाद करता हूं. और आप लोगों को उम्मीद मुझसे यही है कि मैं ओलंपिक मेडल लेके आऊं और आप लोगों को इससे जब अपने कंट्री के लिए अपने मेडल जीते इससे बड़ी और कुछ नहीं.
And that's all we have for you on the news tonight. Thanks for joining us.